Today, I'm going to show you how to stop wasting money on Manus because there's a free open source alternative many people don't know about called Suna that pretty much does the same thing. We're talking website creation, analytics, research, game development, and much more, but in an open source tool that you can customize, host wherever you want, and use as much as you want without worrying about hitting any limits. We're going to go through Suna's architecture, how to set it up locally, and we'll even go through a few of Suna's downsides. But before any of that, let's do a head-to-head comparison between Manus and Suna running a simple task. And trust me, you're going to want to hit subscribe. Okay, so here is the prompt in Suna running locally on my machine, and I'm telling it to create a website with the top 10 Vietnamese restaurants in London. Here I'm using the standard version and not the free version, and here is the exact same prompt in Manus using the standard version because the high effort version cost $199 a month. And there's no way I'm paying for that just to test this out. So I'm going to hit enter and let's let these two cook. No pun intended. Okay, so Suna has done this in 17 steps and the whole process took just over 7 minutes. And if we scroll down to see the final results, this is the page, which looks really nice. I'm going to open it in a new tab. Okay, we've got these hover animations. When you hover over each of them, there are star ratings, signature dishes, the address of each location. I mean, this is really nice. We've got some 4.9 stars, 4 stars, and unfortunately, this one is missing an image. But apart from that, I'm really impressed. I mean, for 8 minutes and in one single shot, this is really good. Now, with Manus, the whole thing took over an hour. So if we take a look at the creating a to-do, that was at 11:04. We can see it has a similar to-do list process as Suna. And if we scroll down to the final task or the final step at the bottom, we can see that's at 12:16. So yes, a really long time. And it wasn't even able to complete the task. So if we take a look over here, we can see all the tasks it was supposed to complete, and it didn't even get halfway before it ran out of free credits. So after upgrading and continuing the task from where it left off, Manus finally finished after about half an hour and deployed my site to a public URL. And here it is. So we have 10 restaurants, 7 of which have images and 3 of which don't. And it looks like it got all the information from timeouts list. So this is number 1 and this is number 10. So I'm not sure how much research it actually did or why it took almost 2 hours to make this. But if you compare it to what Suna created, we can see this looks more visually appealing with nice text over here to introduce the page and some text over here for each restaurant, which Manus didn't seem to include. I've even gone ahead and asked Suna to publish this to AWS Amplify, so you can check out the site yourself by clicking on the link in the description. But for a free and open source tool, this is a very impressive result. So how is Suna able to do this? Well, Suna uses Next.js on the front end, Supabase for user management, conversation history and file storage, Fast API on the back end for the REST endpoints and the LLM integration, and Daytona over here creates isolated environments using Docker to run AI-generated code. Actually, it also uses Redis for caching, but for some reason, that's not in the diagram. Now, you may be thinking, for a tool as complex as Suna, the architecture seems pretty simple, but the real magic lies in the way it connects many third-party services together to create a seamless experience. And that will make a lot more sense when we come to set it up locally. In fact, let's do that now. The setup is fairly involved, so I'm going to run through it quickly and I'll skip a bunch of the obvious steps. But in terms of prerequisites, you'll need to have Docker installed, a Supabase project, and also the Supabase CLI, an Anthropic API key, a Daytona account, a Firecrawl API key for web crawling, a Tavily API key for web search, and you could also add a RapidAI API key for API services, but this is already enough. So once you've cloned the repo, you can add your Supabase credentials, which can be found here, leave Redis as is, add your Anthropic API key, and you can ignore the rest of the fields unless you want to use an AWS service. You can also ignore Grok and OpenRouter as well as Rapid API, add your Tavily API key along with Firecrawl, and these values from Daytona. In fact, when it comes to Daytona, you don't have to install it locally. You can just grab an API key and ignore the rest of this page and follow the installation steps in the README. After running the Supabase migrations, it's important to come to this page and select the Basejump schema, which is used for personal accounts and subscription billing. And then run Docker Compose up in the root of the project. And if all goes well, you should be able to sign up, create an account, and use Suna for whatever you want. Now, I haven't tried hosting this somewhere like DigitalOcean or Hetzner, or given Suna access to MCP servers via Light LLM, but that can't be too difficult, right? Anyway, after using Suna locally for a few hours, here are my initial thoughts. Honestly, nothing has made me more excited than seeing all the log messages in the Docker logs while Suna is completing a task. I mean, it's amazing to watch it work. And with the open Manus repo being archived this month, I feel like Suna is the perfect open source replacement. But there are a few downsides. Suna itself is free, but the Anthropic and OpenAI LLMs are not. I mean, even with Daytona, you can only really use it once or twice before it runs out of free credits. Yes, if you still combine everything you're paying for, it's still a lot cheaper than Manus, but it's a lot to set up initially, especially with all the payment options. The web search also works well, but I found it to be a bit slow at times. This might be my network, but it would be nice if I could use another provider like the Anthropic web search or something from Google. And there are also a few weird bugs, like the search saying it failed when it clearly succeeded, conversations showing up twice instead of once, and a lot of the errors I've experienced don't show up in the UI, only in the logs. But the beauty of an open source tool is that if these bugs and features haven't been addressed now, then maybe somebody has forked them or created a pull request to fix those issues, or maybe even I could do that myself.